you don't want people to know, but you keep battling with it. You keep praying. Each time you say, Jesus, Jesus, when you see people coming, you're silent. In the name of Jesus, I want this thing. I want this thing. Even when your wife or your husband is coming, I want this thing. I want this. Just, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You just turn to praises immediately. Oh Lord, my Lord, my Lord, my Lord, my Lord, do it. I don't want to do it. I don't want to. Somebody will just knock on the door. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I'm praying here. Thank you. Come on, come inside. Jesus, thank you for what you have done for me. Why can't you continue your former prayer? Your former prayer has turned to praises now. Your former prayer has turned to what? Has turned to praises suddenly. Ask your neighbor, when you look at your lives, what do you see? What does Jesus see? If you cannot answer that question, I will leave it for tomorrow. I will leave that for tomorrow. I will leave that question because I want something that will be picking your heart, blinking. You know, when one has a partition, you see, as if sometimes you hold your heart as if you are gone. No, you are not going anywhere. It's only telling you that you are not okay. That is the question you keep thinking about. I will leave you with that question. I will not talk about that today. That this is the question TB Joshua asked me. When I look at my life, what do I see? What does Jesus see? You may see everything is well with you, but to God, it's not well. This is where you see people, suddenly you learn that it's late, or sleep and not wake up. You say, a guy was very happy yesterday, we were dancing, we were promised to go to London, to go for shopping, but suddenly you get home, you learn that it's late. Me, the way he saw his life, it's not the way Jesus. If your brother would have knew that, he's going to leave tomorrow, he would have told you, please take care of my brothers and anything may happen, please, this. They'll be talking to you in parable. By the time it happens, you say, oh, he was telling me all this. Oh, this guy knew. He. Ask yourself once again, when you look at your life, what do you see? What does Jesus see? That is a question for you to answer now. And I will leave you with that question. So some of if you know what God is looking, what you will see, the way God sees your life, if you see life the way God sees it, and you see yourself the way God sees you, you will know how to handle your situation. Some will say, oh no, I want to invest $3 million. I want to do this tomorrow. I want to do this. I want to do that. All those promises, many of these promises, you could not carry out. And many, those promises hit the rock of disappointment. Many are in the graveyards. Someone else is carrying out those promises. So this is why this is TB Joshua for you. As for me, I can only do what Jesus Christ tells me. I can only do so when Jesus Christ tells me to. That is why you just say, oh, this man, I'm still here in the synagogue. If I'm to follow my spirit direction, my own spirit direction, no man has his own spirit, I will have branches all over the world. Because everybody, the demand is so much everywhere. But no, things are not like that. I can only do so when Jesus tells me to. Is this one whom you want your power to touch through me? If God says yes, wow. Are you with me? Is this one whom you want your power to touch through me? If God says yes, I touch. If God says no, I leave you. Are you with me? Is this one whom you want your power to touch through me this day? Yes. Bah. And the result come. Tell your neighbor, is this one whom you want your power to touch through me this day? If yes, wah. If no, that's why I'm coming. If we examine our life, you will find out how much faith you have. Tell your neighbor, if you examine your life, you will find out how much faith in God you have. If you examine your business, you will know how much faith you have. If you examine your marital life, if you examine your career, your finances, your future, everything, yourself, everything, even the way you dress. When I just look at people, the way they dress, the way they move, I know how much faith he has. I don't need to say, are you a Christian or not? If I just see you the way you talk, or the way you talk, I say, thank you. I know you. I don't need to live with you before, no. Even ministers of God, we ministers of God, when you watch on the Christian channel, when you sit down for 3 minutes, listen to ministers of God, you will know how much faith he or she has. Jesus is Lord. Amen? Whom are you talking to? Are they your boys? And some of our program, president of nation are watching. People that are great in anointing than us also are watching our program. You see, I want to tell you, amen? You know, when you stand, you know, you are, God is talking to you, and you are talking to God. Tell your neighbor, if you examine your life, you will find out how much faith you have. Yes, even we ministers of God, the way we talk, arrogantly. Yes, I'm this. Yes, I'm that. I'm the only one that can do this. You can see the way they talk. You can, oh, no, I know how much faith he has. And it's all about faith. Say, all about faith in God. It's all about faith in God. I mean, all about Jesus. It's not how he quoted the Bible or the message he preached, powerful message or whatever he said. Don't cry. Don't be carried away looking at the content of the message and the position he how he positioned himself. I met a friend sometimes, and he was telling me that the Holy Spirit gave him an idea. Are you with me? I say, I met a friend. You want me to mention that friend? Don't worry, we are coming to that. I met a friend sometimes ago. He was telling me Holy Spirit gave him an idea. If Holy Spirit gave you an idea, don't take the credit. Tell your neighbor. Are you with me? I would not say that. It's a parable. I say, I met a friend sometimes ago, and he was telling me that, Holy Spirit gave me an idea. I say, wow! I look at him, and I'm looking at him. He's taking glory. He's taking credit. I know this is not from Holy Spirit. Tell your neighbor, if Holy Spirit gave you an idea, don't take the credit. You say, oh yes, all I'm doing by the power of Holy Ghost. Yes, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. My God. I said, oh. After looking at him, I realized that he was taking the credit. Tell your neighbor, if Holy Spirit gives you an idea, don't take the credit. So you can now examine one's life, how much faith he or she has. Because if Holy Spirit gives you an idea to talk, to preach, to minister, to prophesy, to heal, to deliver, if Holy Spirit gives you this idea, you will not take the credit. The credit belongs to him. Tell your neighbor, if you examine your life, you will find out how much faith you have. I can hear you. How much faith in God you have? Yes. Faith manifested in the small things in our daily life. Look, in Jesus' name. As I'm talking now, I'm saying in Jesus' name before I talk. Look at my hand. In Jesus' name before I raise it. Before I give it this hand, in Jesus' name. Before I return it to this hand, in Jesus' name. As I'm moving my leg, in Jesus' name. If I want to sit down, in Jesus' name. Tell your neighbor, faith manifested in the small things in our daily life. If you examine your life, you will find out how much faith you have in God. Even my brother, you are writing. As you are writing now, you must depend on God to do so. Today, we pray today without necessary faith to release the belief in our hearts. There is power in our mouth, power to deliver, power to heal, power to prophesy, the power here, but the faith to release the power. There is power in our mouth, but the belief in our heart is released by faith out of our mouth. Are you with me? Tell your neighbor, there is power in our mouth. The belief in our heart is released by faith out of our mouth. We pray without necessary faith. saying you don't have faith, because there's no one without faith, but necessary measure, the measure. When Jesus sent his disciple, they came back and they said, "Father, we could not deliver that man, that boy, but we have been delivering many in the past." He said, "Look, you lack the necessary faith to do so, but there is power in you." There is power to raise the dead in you. There is power to raise the dead, to pray, to open the blind, cripple, but necessary faith to release the power you lack. Is useless if it does not spring from faith. Tell your neighbor. In Jesus' name, amen. You only hear yourself, and people around you will hear you, but God will not hear you. In Jesus' name, be healed. You will hear yourself. People around you will hear you, but God does not hear you, because that, in Jesus' name, is not springing from faith. Your prayer is useless if it does not spring from what? From faith. You remember Jesus said, it is not enough to simply hope or pray. Rather, we must say, be gone, be cast out into the sea, be removed. By faith. It is not enough to simply say, to simply hope or say the prayer. It is not enough. Hallelujah. Yeah. Are you with me?
Yeah.
So anyone can pray, but not everyone can say prayer in faith. There is power in our mouth. The belief in our heart is released by faith out of our mouth. Tell your neighbor once again. It's belief in our heart. It's released by faith out of our mouth. There's power. You have power. Because look at what the Bible says in the book of Luke. It says, "Behold, I have given you power to this, power to march, to work on the scorpion and snake and all of that. The power is there for you." There's power. So, and you stop praying for power. It's a wrong prayer. A Christian who say, "I need power, God give me power." Which power do you want again? You are contradicting yourself. necessary faith to release the power. To release the power. If not, the power will remain dormant, unused. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I can hear you.
Amen.
I was listening to one of the confessions of one of our brother, when the lady, a woman, the wife was confessing. You know, look at the crowd. Our intention, our motive of coming here is right to see the face of God. Deliverance, healing, for salvation of your soul. If you are looking for a wife and you enter here, remember your first motive. The primary reason of entering here is first you have a case you need God to solve. After your deliverance, then you can now begin to look at the partner God wants to give you, and such a partner also must be delivered. Then, if there's need to see your man or girl, pastor, I think talking of marriage is a very important issue. You can book an appointment to see your man or girl for counseling and to also see what you are looking at. If I say this is your wife, this is my wife, man or girl too need to examine what I'm looking at in the light of God's word to confirm what I have seen, whether I'm right or wrong. Not just coming and grab a woman for wife. I was listening to some confession when a woman was being delivered. When they were asking the man said, we came here some times ago and we got married. And we got to know ourselves here. If you got to know yourself here, how did you get married? Marriage is not an issue of I look at you and I love you, just like that. It's a thing of Hallelujah. Amen. So I want to leave you because we have a message tomorrow to deliver. I just trying all what has happened today. I try to put all of them together and examine them in the light of God, so you can take your quotable quote, your message. So I think some of the message I've given you just a quote that can run like first quote. When you look at your lives, what do you see? What does Jesus see? You must see what Jesus see. If you see differently, you are gone. What do you see? What does Jesus see? These are two questions. Because when Jesus met this man at the beautiful gate, he was asking for money. He was asking for silver and gold. But Jesus did not see that. When Jesus asked him, "Rise and walk, silver, gold I have not. In the name of Jesus, rise." Peter, amen. When Peter said that, He was looking at Peter and said, "What are you saying? I'm here for money. I'm here for silver and gold." That was why he refused to at first. And Peter walked towards him and tapped his shoulder. Say, "I'm telling you, what you are looking at is not what I'm looking at. You are looking at the money, like many of us, you know, your friend is money. Yeah, our friend is money. Money is just a slice, just a little slice of life. If you have a bread, sliced bread, you have almost 20 slices of bread. Money is just one out of 20. The 19 slices, you cannot afford to lose it. Money just take a slice. 20 slices of bread, when you put them together, you just take one slice. That is money for you in life. So if you are interested in money, everything is money, you work because of money, you go there because of money, you love people because of money, you become this because of money, you can money, and money, money, money. If your money, if there's no money, you cannot come to church. If there's no money, you cannot pray. If there's no money, you will not allow peace to reign in the house. Husband and wife, you see some husband, their eyes will become wide. What happened? There is no money. Money is not everything. Money is just what? A slice. Out of 20 slices, it's just one. The remaining 19 slices is a different thing. Money is just one. If you allow money to control you, it means you are gone. You want to buy this suit, you want to buy this wear, you want to buy car, you want to buy this, you want to buy land, you want to do this. We ministers of God, before you attend to people, you need money. You collect money, you ask people to bring money, you poor from loaners, everyone, money, 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 money. You love money so much? No. Money is just a slice. People can know if you have money. People can know if you don't have money. Because it will show your face that you are not happy. When you are not happy, they say, "Look at your brother. He has no money." They say, "Look at your brother. He has no money. Brother, what is happening? I don't have money." I said it. So money has taken control. No. So we talk tomorrow. We're trying to bring all these quotes to message tomorrow. Like, first question: how do you see your life? When you look at your lives, what do you see? What does Jesus see? You see money. You see houses. You see mansions. You see fame. Your name is everywhere. You see sickness, you see disease, you see fear. You need to know what God sees. Rise up for prayer. Right now, open your lips and give thanks to God. Don't let your situation control the direction of your prayer. Tell your neighbor, don't let your situation control the direction of your prayer. You know what I mean? When you are sick, when I say, "Let us pray," when you are sick, you begin to say, "Be God, hear me." God, hear me. God, hear me. May your situation control the direction of your prayer. But when you are happy, you say, God, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It means your condition control the direction of your prayer. When you are without money, you say, ah, God, please, I'm poor. Bless me. Bless me. And if Satan knows that it is your situation that controls the direction of your prayer, you will never have peace. Because he will not want you to say, thank you, Jesus. Because you know that thank you, Jesus, is a blessing. He will not allow you for a moment to say, thank you, Jesus. If Satan know that your situation control the direction of your prayer, he will not allow you, he will never allow you to say, thank you, Jesus, for a moment. Imagine you have a father, you cannot say, thank you, father. Good morning, daddy. You always say, give me healing, give me bread, give me biscuit, give me this. No, it's become an embarrassment. Very big one. So, tell your neighbor, don't allow your situation. Don't allow your condition. Control the direction of your prayer. Control the direction of your prayer. I can hear you. I can hear you. I call it condition, because when the money is in your pocket, you get, hey, money is at home. Say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm here to thank you. You have answered my prayer. That is condition. I use that condition. But situation, maybe you are sick or no money in the pocket. Don't allow your condition. Don't allow your situation control the direction of your prayer. So, we are just, our Christian life, those things that can make us move or grow,